The next type of differential equations that we are going to study is the exact differential equations. The standard form of first order and first degree differential equations is mdx plus ndy equal to 0, where m and n are functions of both the variables or a single variable or constants. The necessary and sufficient condition for this differential equation to be exact is partial derivative of m with respect to y is equal to partial derivative of n with respect to x. Note that this condition is necessary and sufficient. And when it is both necessary and sufficient, once you realize that these two partial derivatives are equal, you can just solve it with the ready-made formulas. The formula goes something like this. Integrate m with respect to x, treating y as a constant, plus integrate those terms in n which do not contain x equal to constant. The other way to obtain the solution is integrate n with respect to y, treating x as a constant, and add to it integration of those terms in m which do not contain y. These are the two formulas to obtain the solutions. Now we will see in detail how these two things come and what is the condition for exactness and what has it to do with partial differentiation. To do that, we will start with an example. Let us consider the function z, which constitutes of two variables x and y, and let this function be x squared y cube plus x raised to 4 plus y raised to 5 plus 6. Do you remember the chain rule of differentiation for partial derivatives? Let's recall that. So let's say z is a function of x and y, and through x and y it is a function of t. If I want to write dz by dt, I will say dabba z by dabba x into dx by dt plus dabba z by dabba y into dy by dt. Don't say dabba x by dabba t, because there is only one independent variable as far as x and y are concerned. Okay? This is the application of chain rule of partial differentiation. In the differential form, we may write this as dz equal to dabba z by dabba x dx plus dabba z by dabba y dy. So we have just dropped the dt terms. Now if I say that z is a constant, will dz by dt be 0? Yes. Now if z is constant and dz by dt is 0, this whole term would be 0. And as a result of that, this term will also be equal to 0. Does this expression appear similar to our standard form? Mdx plus ndy equal to 0? Yes. Let's obtain the partial derivatives of z. Dabba z by dabba x is 2xy cube plus 4x cube. What is dabba z by dabba y? 3x squared y squared plus 5y raised to 4. And now let us obtain the mixed partial derivative. So we will differentiate dabba z by dabba x with respect to y, which will give us 6xy squared. And let us differentiate dabba z by dabba y with respect to y, which will be 6xy squared. And we know that for this function, the commutative property of partial differentiation is satisfied. And by commutation, we mean the order of the differentiation can be changed. Both have given us 6xy squared. If we assume that dabba z by dabba x is m and dabba z by dabba y is n, then we will get this: dabba m by dabba y equal to 6xy squared, and dabba n by dabba x is also 6xy. This is the condition for exactness. Till now it appears that the conditions which we learn under the exact differential equations have something to do with the commutative property of partial differentiation. Now we will see the way these solutions are designed. What happens if we integrate m? M is what? M is now 2xy cube plus 4x cube. So if we integrate m with respect to x, treating y as a constant, what will we get? We will get x squared y cube plus x raised to 4. Then what happens if we integrate n with respect to y without imposing the condition that there should not be any x terms? We will get x squared y cube plus y raised to 5. Because we say no x, this term does not come. And the reason why we say no x is, this has already been considered here. The original solution says, integrate only those terms in n which do not contain x. Now why is this no x condition? This is because we have already considered this term here, and that's why we say no x. There should not be any x term here. If it is there, just ignore it. So the solution is now x squared y cube plus x raised to 4 plus y raised to 5 equal to constant. The original function was plus 6 or something, but we know that this 6 can be adjusted in the arbitrary constant. Now let's see what happens if we apply the second solution. Here we will consider n, its integration with respect to y, treating x as a constant. So we will now get this term, x squared y cube plus y raised to 5. And now we will integrate m without considering those terms which contain y. So as a result of that, this term won't come, because in m there are two terms. One contains y, the other one does not contain y. If we integrate that term which contains y, we will have this term repeated. And that's the reason these two conditions are imposed, no y. Now the last part, why is this the solution? While setting the problem itself, they start with such a function. And they just let this function to be a constant. So obviously its derivative will be zero. And that is what gives rise to the exact differential equation, m dx plus n dy equal to 0, where dabba m by dabba y is equal to dabba n by dabba x. Why is this true? This is true because of the commutative property of partial differentiation. Once you get this, then the solution part is very easy. You have now understood that no x and no y part should be considered to avoid repetition of the same function x squared y cube, which appears in both the integrals. So this is the method and its explanation, which is based on the commutative property of partial differentiation. If you randomly pick m and n, it is highly unlikely that the differential equation would be exact. The way they set the exact differential equation, or they form the exact differential equation, is they start with a multivariable function and they just take its first order partial derivatives with respect to x and with respect to y. They just put them here, it automatically becomes exact because of the commutative property. Dabba 2z by dabba x dabba y is equal to dabba 2z by dabba x, sorry, dabba y. So the entire analysis or solution of exact differential equations is based on this particular property.